On the dawn of January 23, 1958, after the coup that put an end to the dictatorship, without any military support and with a rejection of most of society, Pérez Jiménez fled Venezuela to the Dominican Republic, where this country's president at the time, General Rafael Leonidas Trujillo, was waiting for him. He was replaced with a military board presided by Wolfgang Larrazábal. This was the headline on the newspaper Panorama about the overthrowing of Pérez Jiménez. Since then, and to this day, every January 23rd is celebrated as a day of rejoice in Venezuela, when its citizens remember the importance of democracy and the end of an era of military control that had led the country throughout its history. That same year, the nominations and mandates continued for Captain Abdelnour, furthering his career preparation. In March, by disposition of the Governing Board of the Republic of Venezuela and Resolution Number 318, he was named Deputy Commander of the Destroyer Zulia. The Destroyer Zulia was a warship that was built by the British in 1951. This one, alongside the Esparta and Aragua, were three of the majestic destroyers of the Venezuelan Army and had been christened FNV, its Spanish initials for Venezuelan Armed Forces. In April, like all the nominations and rulings made for Captain Abdelnour, the Governing Board of the Republic of Venezuela and Resolution Number 508, dated April 1st, 1958, appointed him Assistant to the Military House. This was signed by Colonel Jesus Manuel Pérez Morales, General Chief of Staff. During this period until 1959, he fulfilled different missions, and due to his military status and actions during his career, he received the order to escort Fidel Castro. He is appointed official aide to tend to Fidel Castro during his visit to Venezuela. He was also in charge of organizing the purchase of an airplane to help Cuba recover its democracy and overthrow dictator Batista. These were the intentions manifested by Fidel Castro and the revolutionaries that accompanied him. Subsequently, many months of activity and tension came for Venezuela. On July 23, 1958, the military board led by Rear Admiral Wolfgang Larrazábal assumed power and gathered at the Quinta La Guzmania to analyze Venezuela's destiny after the overthrown regimen of Marcos Pérez Jiménez. The tension in town was so much that the Venezuelans launched themselves onto the streets. Aware of this, the political parties and other popular organizations were getting ready to fight the schemers. All negotiations failed, and after several hours passed, they informed the press that the cabinet meeting had been moved to the country's capital. But not before the sensational news was advertised that the government had been relocated to the Department of Vargas, under the protection of the fleet that displayed its decision to maintain the atmosphere of liberty that prevailed in the country. On July 2, 1958, the Governing Board and its President Rear Admiral Wolfgang Larrazábal stated their approach that the industry and commerce would absorb 50,000 unemployed people if the commercial treaty was to take place with the United States. Several days later, the campaign pro-Venezuela was being inaugurated in the college town. Wolfgang Larrazábal declared the campaign pro-national product consumption. He thought that defending this industry would lead Venezuela to economic freedom. Representatives of the active forces of politics and Representative Porter, a special guest, attended the inauguration where the support for Venezuelan consumer products got its start. During the following months, Rear Admiral Wolfgang Larrazábal would create more motions. In July, there was a presentation of the credentials of Ambassador Extraordinary and Plenipotentiary of the Republic of Mexico, Dr. Pedro Ferizola. After he presented the documents that credited him as a representative of his country before the Venezuelan government, he exchanged a few brief words with the Rear Admiral Larrazábal. In September, following his task of continuing to support the Venezuelan economy and balancing the cost of living for Venezuelans, Rear Admiral Larrazábal inaugurates the first project of a series of establishments that would be called Automercado de Mercifrica, whose objective was to extend the campaign for reducing the cost of living to the whole country. With Mercifrica, government offices experimented with the possibility of establishing a national market institute or a minimum price institute. On October 1958, construction started on what would become one of the architectural icons of Caracas, the Helicoid, which projected itself as the only mall in Latin America at the time.